Finally, you say you like nothing better than to cuddle up with a good ghost story. Well, has our man Mike Randall got a tip for you?
It's one of the tinier shops in Allentown. You could miss it if you weren't looking for it. It's called the Haunted Bookshop. The name alone sends chills up your spine. It's the kind of spot you'd expect to find creaky doors and old books about ghosts and goblins, and heaven only knows what other kinds of surprises lurking among the shadows.
Hiya, Mike. Welcome to the Haunted Bookshop.
Hi, nice to see you.
Meet Robert Hatch, the proprietor of this unusual bookstore. It appears that he is the only spirit, earthly or otherwise, who inhabits the place. Sure, there are enough books about spooks to give anyone a bevy of nightmares, but what do you expect from a place called the Haunted Bookshop?
How did you ever come up with the name The Haunted Bookshop?
Simple. Christopher Morley, one of your great writers, wrote a book called The Haunted Bookshop. And all he imagined was it would be haunted by the spirits of dead authors.
So in other words, the place isn't really haunted then?
Oh, no, Mike, no. I've never seen anything resembling a ghost here, really. You can take it from me.
Well, isn't that false advertising if you call it The Haunted Bookshop and it's not really haunted?
Well, I hope not. No, it isn't, because everybody knows there's no ghosts in this bookshop. There may be in other bookshops, but there isn't one in this one.
It's not that Robert wouldn't like to have a ghost.
Well, I'd rather have lady ghosts.
Meanwhile, he'll keep the door open to all friendly spirits interested in things that go bump in the night. At the Haunted Bookshop, this is Mike Randall for Eyewitness News.
Okay, guys, what's the most frightening book?